In wrestling, a takedown is one of the biggest objectives that you have to complete, and it's one of the most difficult ones as well. Even though you train it the day after you learn a stance, it is still one of the hardest things to accomplish. In practice, they teach you taking someone down in a bunch of different steps. They teach you in a setup, a level change, a shot, and a finish. And a lot of the time, in a match and in practice, our brain thinks this way. We take all the setups we know and we categorize them under the same thing. We take all the shots we know and we categorize them. We take all the level changes we know and we categorize them. We take all the finishes we know and we categorize them. But it's very important that you understand how each of these things work, what they aim to accomplish, okay? In a setup, you are trying to lower your opponent's defenses. And there's two different types of setups. You are trying to lower your opponent's defenses so you can level change past his head and his arms and shoot deep on his legs so you can take him down. Now there's a setup that you have from contact, and there's a setup that you have from no contact. There's a bunch of different setups. For example, a setup from contact could be like, you have an inside tie, you grab the inner bicep, and you do a slide by. It can be as simple as you let someone get inside control, and you pop the elbows up, level change, and shoot. These are things you do so you can get to the legs while you're already having contact with your opponent, while he's already touching you, while there's already like pressure being exerted. Now, the other type of setup is setups from no contact. A setup from no contact means that exactly that, he's not touching you. This is before you guys have tied up. This is before you guys have like a hand on each other's neck, or you guys are holding hands or whatever you do. But the point being that there are a bunch of different setups, okay? There are a bunch of different setups that you can use. The exact same thing with level change, all right? You can level change, circle two steps left and shoot. You can level change, circle two steps right and shoot. You can level change low. Like, and the way you level change is different. Sometimes you level change with an arm drag, sometimes, you know what I mean? It's very, very different, and it's specific to each shot you want to take. All the different level changes that you learn and that you have for yourself in your mind, you put under the level change column. Right now, there's a bunch of different types of shots too. There's a single leg, double leg, high crotch. There's a bunch of different types of shots. All right, and same thing. You just categorize them. And then off that shot, you go to a finish, right? Super linear, you know what I mean? There's a clear direction you need to go in. There's obviously gonna be a lot more in your list than mine because. One thing that bad wrestlers do is they go into a match with a list like this, just a list like this. And what good wrestlers do is, like in football, they draw a game plan. They know exactly which dot, like from their setup to their level change, they know exactly which direction they're going in. They know exactly, before they even set up, they know what setup they're going to do, what level change they're going to do, what shot they're going to do, and what finish they're going to do. Okay, this is very important. This improves the speed of your takedown tenfold. By knowing what you're gonna do before you do it, it makes you so much faster. As wrestling goes, everyone knows, oftentimes your shot doesn't exactly go the path that you want it to. Oftentimes you get stopped. You get stopped at the single leg, or you get stopped at the double leg. And from that point, then you have to switch to something else in your list. You have to change the direction you're going in so you can eventually get the 2 points, so you can eventually get the finish. But the point is that no matter where you get stopped, if it's at your setup, then you start back from square one. If it's at your level change, sometimes you have to go backwards. Sometimes you can go forwards, like if they get you in a front headlock, you can hit a dump or something. You know what I mean? The point is you have to connect all the dots. And the best way to take someone down is by having the dots already connected before you even start drawing. Before you even try to get to the pin, you should have all your dots connected in your head. And you should be, in practice, you should be able to identify what you can hit. If you're stuffed on a high crotch, then you should be able to know exactly what you can hit from that position, from that stuffed position. You should know what you can hit. And now, I know that was really complicated and I might have confused you guys a lot and I might have repeated a lot. This was real complicated for me. This was hard for me to understand as a new wrestler. But the whole point of it is to connect, is to have all these dots connected, right, in real time, as quickly as possible. You want as little time in between the connection of all these dots as possible. So if you guys liked that video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. I post a new video every day. But until next time, I'll see you guys. Peace.